हेलो नमस्ते, माई सेल्फ रोहिणी मिर्गू, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर एट वॉल्चन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, टॉकिंग अबाउट द डेप्थ ऑफ पेनिट्रेशन और स्किन डेप्थ। लर्निंग आउटकम्स, एट द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो यू विल बी एबल टू डिराइव द इक्वेशन फॉर स्किन डेप्थ, which is also called as depth of penetration. Before I proceed further, one practical question I want to ask to you. There are two figures shown. In the first figure, the electromagnetic wave is propagating between the antenna and a tower. In the second case, there is a tape or a radio which is radiating a sound wave. So here my question is, in figure one, whether communication between antenna and tower depends on distance, and in figure 2, whether the audio signal's audibility is dependent on distance. That is my question. Is the electromagnetic wave propagation is dependent on distance? This is a simple way my question is. Hopefully you know the answer, and hopefully your answer is yes in both the cases. The signal received at the receiving end depends on distance between the transmitting point and receiving point. The signal decays as the distance increases. As in the case of radio or a tape, the audibility of the radio signal to the human ear reduces as the person moves away from radio. All of you must be agreed with this. If I'm closer to the radio or a tape, I can hear very good sound, but when I move away from it, the audibility goes on reducing. So, is the audibility of sound from tape or radio is same if we consider the medium as air, water or any solid object? Now, I can give an example here, like if I'm listening the tape keeping the ear plug and I'm just listening it when the wave is getting captured from air and I'm listening, and the audibility, whether it is different. And if the medium of transmission is a water, if I'm swimming and I'm listening, so medium of transmission is not air but a water in that case. So in that case, whether the audibility of the sound is different. So, is same. My question was, is it same? So, the answer for it is no. The audibility of radio signal to human depends upon the medium in which the wave travels. So, the electromagnetic wave propagation depends on distance as well as the medium in which it propagates. So, the conclusion of the electromagnetic wave propagation in different media, I can say that electromagnetic wave propagation is dependent on the distance as well as on the medium. This is because why the signal is decaying. This is because the wave attenuates during propagation. The electromagnetic wave goes on attenuating as it moves along the in the medium, and the amount of attenuation depends on the distance or increases as per the distance. The amount of attenuation depends on the propagation medium. Now you may say, in all the cases whether the wave gets attenuated. Yes, in all the cases the wave gets attenuated. There is the ideal condition that we consider as a free space where the wave should not get attenuated. The wave is not attenuated. The ideal is the free space, is the medium. But as you know that nothing in the world is ideal. These are the theoretical concepts, but actually in air, in the any other medium, the wave gets attenuated. And the amount of attenuation is dependent on the propagation medium. Now I come to the point of the skin depth. So what is skin depth? Let us see its definition. Skin depth, or the depth of penetration, is defined as that depth in which the wave has been attenuated to 1/p, 1/e. in which the wave has been attenuated to 1 upon e. 1 upon e of what? 1 upon e of its original value. So that is, 1 upon e, if I calculate, it's approximately 37% of its original value. So if I see, you can see here, the wave is propagating and there is the medium change, and the wave is getting penetrated into the another medium. And when this penetration, when it's the wave amplitude reduces to 1 upon e, so that much penetration is called as a skin depth. So here also I have shown few diagrams. This is the same one where the wave is getting penetrated to the distance where the signal has been attenuated to 1 upon e or remained as 1 upon e. And on this side, if you can see, this wave is getting propagated. Maybe if I consider this, maybe some solid medium, and then getting penetrated into that solid medium. And the skin depth that I can define is the value when this amount of attenuation is reduced to 1 upon, the signal is reduced to 1 upon e of its original value, or when the signal is reduced to 37% of its original value. So that distance I'll consider as a skin depth. So we are talking about the depth of penetration. Here I consider the wave which is having the amplitude or the magnitude E by 0 is penetrating into this conducting medium. I consider there is a conducting medium from x equal to 0 and the wave is propagating along x direction. When the wave is getting penetrated into this conducting medium, the wave is getting attenuated. And when it reaches to 37% of its original value, that is E by 0, I consider this distance as x1, and from x equal to 0 to x equal to x1, I'll consider this as a depth of penetration. So here I'm considering the wave is transmitted from conducting medium from x equal to 0. When the electromagnetic wave is propagating, it has some magnitude and some propagation constant. So Ey equal to Ey0 e raised to minus gamma x, where gamma is the propagation constant, which has two terms, alpha and j beta. So some real term and the imaginary term, unit is per meter, where alpha is called as attenuation constant. The real term is called attenuation constants in Nepper per meter. The imaginary term, which is beta, is called phase constant, which is radians per meter. I can substitute these values in my equation, and my equation will reduce to Ey equal to Ey0 e raised to minus alpha x e raised to minus j beta x. So gamma is replaced by alpha and j beta. In this, the real term, which is e raised to minus alpha x, indicates attenuation. At x equal to 0, Ey is Ey0, as you can see here. X equal to 0, Ey is Ey0. If I consider this as x equal to x1, Ey is equal to Ey0 upon e. So I can say at x equal to x1, the wave amplitude is reduced to 1 upon e times of its value at x equal to 0. So this 1 upon e is nothing but 37% of its value at x equal to 0. So let us derive the equation of skin depth. As per the definition of skin depth or depth of penetration, alpha into delta is 1, or delta is equal to 1 upon alpha. And this alpha can be given as omega under root omega mu epsilon upon 2 into under root 1 plus sigma square upon omega epsilon square minus 1. So delta is 1 upon alpha, so 1 upon this term will give me delta. So this is in general. But if I want to derive this skin depth or depth of penetration for a conducting medium, let us do that. For that, I'll consider the equation of propagation. Propagation constant gamma square equal to j omega mu sigma plus j omega epsilon. If I take sigma outside as a constant term or a common factor, j omega mu sigma into the bracket, here it comes 1, and this term is divided by sigma because I have taken sigma as a common factor outside. And for a good conductor, sigma upon omega epsilon is much greater than 1, isn't it? It is much greater than 1. So if why it is greater than 1? Because it's a conducting medium, so sigma should be greater than 1. As sigma is higher, but here it comes in the denominator. So this term is going to be much less than 1. So I can ignore this term in front with respect to this one, and my term of gamma square will be equal to omega square omega mu sigma j omega mu sigma. So gamma, if I derive for gamma, gamma can also be given as alpha plus j beta. So if I find out gamma square, which is equal to, or squaring on both side, I'll get it is alpha square minus beta square plus 2j alpha beta. So if I compare this equation with the equation 2, this is my equation 2. Gamma square is j square omega mu sigma, and here gamma square is this. So if I see in equation 2, there is no real term at all. Only imaginary term is there, which is omega mu sigma. So if I compare this gamma square with the equation 2 gamma square, I'll get alpha square minus beta square, which is the real term, is 0. And the imaginary term, which is 2 alpha beta, is equal to omega mu sigma. But the conclusion I can find out from alpha square minus beta square as alpha is equal to beta. So as alpha equal to beta, I can substitute that in the equation of 2 alpha beta. So I'll get it as 2 alpha square is equal to omega mu sigma. And hence, alpha from this equation can be determined as under root omega mu sigma upon 2. But as we know that delta is a skin depth, which is given as 1 upon alpha. So delta can be given as under root 2 omega mu sigma in meters. So this is the skin depth equation. As you can see in this equation, skin depth is dependent on the frequency as well as the medium constants mu and sigma. These are the references used for preparing this video. Thank you.